Hello chess friends and welcome to the channel. In today's video, one game from round 5 of the European Team Championship 2019. This important tournament is a 9-round biennial team event open to all the European chess federations. 40 nations, 40 teams are playing this year. The defending champions are Azerbaijan in the open category and Russia among the women. After 4 rounds, 4 teams are leading the tournament. They are Armenia, Ukraine, Russia and England. I'm going to show you the game between Gabriel Jones and Vladimir Onischuk in the match between England and Ukraine. Let's get started. Gabriel Jones with the white pieces opens with e4. Here comes e5, knight to f3, knight to c6, bishop to b5. This is the Ruy Lopez. Knight to f6 attacking the pawn is a Berlin defense. Short castle and knight captures on e4. Rook to e1 attacking both the knight and the pawn. Knight back to d6. Now, after knight captures on e5, of course, it's not possible to capture this bishop with the knight because knight captures on c6 with the discovery check wins the queen and also the game. But after bishop to e7, that shields the king, and now this bishop must move back. Bishop back to f1. Knight captures, rook captures on e5, and short castle for black. d4, all normal stuff. Bishop to f6 attacking the rook. Rook back to e1 and rook to e8. Now, in this position, the most played move for white is c3, defending this pawn, because the queen is now defending the pawn, but the queen is sort of overloaded. Instead, Gawain Jones plays another good move, bishop to f4. Here comes rook captures on e1, the queen recaptures on e1, and now knight back to e8. The idea is clear, is to clear the d-file so that the pawn can advance. But why not bishop captures on d4? Let's go back one move. Bishop captures on d4 is playable. Here comes bishop captures on d6, and now black must pay attention because bishop captures on b2 is now a terrible blunder. In fact, here comes bishop captures on c7 with tempo against the queen. This is a deflection. The queen can't capture the bishop. If not, is checkmating one. After queen back to f8, knight to c3, bishop captures on a1, queen captures on a1, and here we must evaluate the position. Black is up the exchange, but down a piece, behind in development and against the bishop pair, it's more than +2. So after bishop captures, not bishop captures on d2, but c captures on d6, here comes c3, bishop back to f6, and even if black is a pawn up, these two pawns are doubled and isolated, and even if black has the bishop pair, his development is really slow. So in this position, let's say that the game is equal, but truth is that white probably is also a bit better. So let's go back to our game. After knight to e8 instead of bishop captures, here comes knight to c3, and this is a bit risky. Of course, white goes for a fast development. Bishop captures on d4 now works better. Knight to d5, and again there is this terrible jump. It seems that the square is defended twice, but again there is this terrible threat of queen to e8 checkmate. So in this position, again, bishop captures on b2 is a blunder, and not to make the video too long, but in the description below the video, I put for you 2 lines with this bishop captures on b2 if you want to watch them on chessbase. So in this position, d6, closing this diagonal, is the best move, and it was Onischuk played. Here comes bishop to g5 against the queen. Even if the bishop isn't pressed, this is another deflection. With f6, the bishop must move back, but this diagonal is a bit weaker than before. Bishop to h4, now bishop captures on b2, is now playable. Rook to b1, and bishop back to e5. After f4 attacking the bishop, I have 4 games in database, 3 draws and 1 victory for white. Maria Musichuk against Katerina Lagdon played this year in March. So in this position, c6 played in the game is the only move played by all the black players, but there is an alternative. Let's go back one move. The bishop can move to d4, we check. Let's watch briefly this line. Bishop to d4, we check. King to h1. Now c6. Knight to e7, we check. King to h8. Bishop to d3. d5 now controlling e4 so that the queen can't create the battery against h7. But after queen to e2, with the idea of queen to h5, black must defend carefully because white is dangerous. So let's go back to our game. We said f4, black doesn't move the bishop away, he continues with c6. F captures on e5, c captures on d5, and e captures on f6. Knight captures, bishop to d3, bishop to d7, and queen to g3, attacking d6. Gawain Jones is following the Onischuk game against Caterina Lagner. Here comes bishop to c6, with the bishop that is protecting b7, because there is the rook on the b5. Now the queen is also protecting d6. With bishop to g5, the game is now original and equal, because Maria played bishop to f5, but bishop to g5 is a bit better. Let's go back one move. In this position, it seems that rook to f1 is a good idea, but doesn't work, because the queen can move away, we check. Queen to b6, we check. King to h1, and after knight to e4, there is a little advantage, or, see, there is some advantage for black. So, let's go back to our game. We said bishop to g5, the game is now original. With king to h8, black's idea is to unpin this pawn, but this is a mistake. Probably a6 and bishop to b5 is the best idea for black, because let's remember that black is 2 pawns up, even if the game is equal. So even another couple of double pawns, or still losing one pawn, is not so terrible, because white is on the attack. Queen to h4, now with the threat of checkmate in one after bishop removes the only defender of f7. So queen to g8 protecting, sorry, not f7, of h7. So queen to g8 protecting h7, but after bishop captures and g captures, white is really better now. So what to do? With queen captures on f6, we check. There is queen to g7. Queen captures on d6, but this line just gives white a small edge. After g captures on f6, rook to f1 is the best attacking move. In fact, here must come rook to f8, rook captures, queen captures, we check, is now different. After queen to g7, queen to d8, we check, queen to g8, queen captures on d6, there is much more activity in white's position and some real advantage for white. Maybe still difficult to win the game, but black can only hope to hold the game. Let's go back to our game. After g captures on f6, not rook to f1, but rook to b4, played by Gawain Jones, is an inaccuracy at best. Here comes f5 instead of rook to f8. This is a mistake that brings back white in a winning position. Bishop captures on f5. Rook to f8 now is another mistake. Let's go back one move. d4 is the best idea, because the queen must capture. We check. Queen to g7, and because there is this threat, white is almost forced to change the queens. Queen captures, king captures. Rook to g4, we check. King to h6. Of course, white is better, but this is the best idea for black, trying to hold this complicated endgame. Let's go back to our game. Instead, after bishop captures, here comes rook to f8, and this is another mistake, because the white rook moves to g4, attacking the queen. Queen to f7, the bishop is under attack. Rook to g5, one defender is enough, because the queen is in front of the rook. Bishop back to e8 is a good move, because the bishop and the queen are now protecting h5, or if not, this rook will move to h5. Here comes h3 that clears h2, but more than that is a sort of waiting move. What to do for black? Probably a6 and wait for white's plan on how to win this game. Instead, here comes rook to g8, and this is the last mistake. Here comes a beautiful move, bishop to e6, another deflection. It seems that the deflection is the theme of this game, and after bishop to e6, Onischuk resigns. In fact, this reflection wins the queen. Let's watch what happens. If black continues with the best move, of course, is to capture the bishop. Here comes queen to d5, we check, and if the rook moves to g7, it's checkmate on g7. So the queen must move to e5, but rook captures, d captures, queen captures, we check, we'll also win the bishop after rook to g7, and queen captures, on e8 we check, and of course this endgame is completely winning. So it was a short game, a nice victory by Gawain Jones, but England lost the match against Ukraine. In fact, David Howell lost a long fight against Volokitin, and McShane played a terrible blunder in a completely equal position against Kuzubov. After 5 rounds, Ukraine and Russia are leading the tournament, behind them Slovenia and Germany. Our video is over, I thank you very much for watching, and see you soon. Goodbye!